you're actually sore, make sure you go through our warm-up, our stretches. Spend extra time on them. Make sure you're stretching before we get into the workout. Want everything moving right.
And warm-up today is going to be a little bit longer. Make sure all the muscles are firing. We're moving correctly before we get into the big workout. Warm-up is going to be 2 rounds of 15 glute bridges, 15 hollow rocks, and 15 scap protraction. We'll go through all three of those, starting with glute bridges. You're going to be laying down on your back like we would for a sit-up. From here, just squeezing your glutes to lift up the hips and back down. If you need to, you can use a kettlebell to add a little bit of weight. Set down that low abdomen and squeeze the glutes up and down. Hollow rocks. In your hollow rock, most important thing, make sure that low back stays on the floor. So low back is on the floor, my shoulders are up. Now you can bend your legs, straighten them. Really want to challenge yourself. Put your arms up overhead. Again, we're just warming up. So we're in this nice position, low back on the floor, just rocking back and forth. From here, we'll do scap protraction, another shoulder warm-up. Flip over to that push-up position. All we're working on is shoulders. Just pushing up as tall as you can, and then relax. Just like the top of a push-up movement. 2 rounds of 15 on each of those movements. Strength for today, keeping with our max rep scheme, we're testing our strength this week. You're gonna set a 2 minute clock and just do as many kettlebell swings as you can in that 2 minutes. That's it, just 2 minutes of strength. So go all out. On your kettlebell swing, grabbing the kettlebells, shoulders squeeze together. There's gonna be a slight bend in my knee. Lean forward just enough for my wrists to clear my hamstrings. And I don't want to be bending all the way over. So slight bend, lean forward just enough to touch my inner thigh. And from here, I'm squeezing my butt, driving my heel, and sending that kettlebell up overhead. Trying to keep that core tight the whole time. 2 minutes, as many kettlebell swings as you can, then go strength. From there, we're gonna get into our cardio. Got a long chipper today. There's a 20-minute time cap, so it's a 20-minute clock. If you don't finish it within 20 minutes, that's okay. Just try to get as much as you've done. If you do finish before that 20 minutes, congratulations. Right, starting with monster, just like our suicide run. Starting at one line, running out, down, returning back to our starting line, going out to the next line, and so forth. From there, 50 V-ups, 50 push-ups, 50 single leg lateral hops, 50 bent over rows, 50 Superman rocks, 50 Russian twists, finishing up with another monster. So goblet squats, grabbing our kettlebell, you guys can hold it up against your chest with a bell, you can pull it upside down using the handles, either one works, but core tight, setting the hips back, hips below the knees, then back up to full extension. After goblet squats or V-ups, or tuck-ups, whichever you can do, starting in that hollow position again, if the low back is on the floor, the goal is to sit up, touch your toes, and back down. Notice my legs and my torso move at the same time. They both come up, they both come down. If you need to, you can do the tuck version. After V-ups, push-ups. Starting in that fully extended position like we did with our scap protractions. Going down to the ground, chest and thighs touch, then all the way up and then back. Go lay down. From there, we have single leg lateral hops. Here's a new movement. Just going to be standing on one foot, choose a line to stand on. All we want to do is hop side to side over that line. Now, on these hops, it's 50 total, so you only have to do 25 on each side. Every time you cross the line, you can go ahead and count. For example, I'm standing on my right foot, so we're going to do 25 on my right leg, then 25 on my left. So we're going to jump once, back of the line, two, three, four, bent over rows, grabbing my two kettlebells, leaning forward, almost like I'm going into deadlift, my shoulders are squeezed back, my core is tight, from here I'm pulling the kettlebell up to my ribcage, keeping my elbows close, don't move flat to the side, keep them close, touch your ribs, back down, bent over rows.
After your 50 bent over rows, Superman rocks. Just opposite of Hall rocks. So we're going to be on our belly this time. Again, feet, shoulders, and off the floor. Rocks back and forth. Keeping the core tight. Ideally, we want our ankles, heels, knees squeezed together. Arms right next to our ears. Then, we do Russian kiss. Another movement with our kettlebell. You don't have to use a kettlebell if it's too heavy. You can just use your hands. But feet up off the floor in a seated upright position, touching each side. And again, every time we go to one side, it counts as one. One, two, three, so on. And then finishing up with that monster run. Got 20 minutes. Hope you can get it done. Post your time in the section below. Also post how many kettlebell swings you got so we can keep track of that. And we can go back and look at our results when we retest a few months from now. Have a good one.